Welcome back, guys, and a big congratulations to all of the students who have cleared the first round of Virtusa successfully. You are the top 2500 students out of the 50,000 students who applied, right? And according to our knowledge, anyone who have solved 3 or 3 plus questions, they have been selected. And as per our prediction, the questions were not that hard, they were easy, right? Most of them are implementation based and some were even one liners, okay? So but now the things will change. Now in the round 2, the questions will be a lot more difficult, because out of the 2500 students, only 100 students will be selected for round 2. Okay, and according to the previous formats, I think there will be 3 questions and you will have 90 minutes to solve those 3 coding questions. Okay, and I think you will have only 3 languages, Python, Java or C Sharp. Okay, so let's start. We don't have any knowledge, nobody knows what kind of questions might come in Virtusa, because there is no particular syllabus, but we'll give you our assumption, what we think is important and what might come in Virtusa round 2. Okay, so first and foremost, learn DP, dynamic programming, because dynamic programming is really important. Some questions of DP even came in the round 1. Okay, and what topics to study in dynamic programming? So firstly, understand and learn subset sum. This is a pretty popular, pretty interesting question of DP. After that, learn 01 knapsack. These are some few problems that I'm mentioning, and you know, you must have a basic knowledge of how these problem works. Okay, and after that, learn edit distance. These are not just randomly given DP algo, these are very important algo, and you know, if you just read them once, you might actually have an idea on how to solve other DP problems also. Okay, and after that, a very famous problem, egg dropping. Okay, this is a really, really interesting problem. Look at it. And I think cutting rod is also a very nice problem. Okay, so I think you should study these problems in DP. And after that, you know, you the main logic for giving me me to give you these DP problems is to, you know, just solve these and get an idea on how to solve DP problems, because the questions, they might be a little bit different, but the logic they incorporate is, you know, something of mismatch from all these algos. So study them, and these are the prerequisite or basic knowledge that you should have before you attend round 2, because I assume that round 2 will be really, really hard. Okay, so for graph, study graph also. Okay, for graph, don't go into a lot of depth. Study BFS and study DFS. These are the very basics, and get learn coloring notes. Okay, coloring notes, how to color notes with different color. This is a very popular question. And after that, study, let's say Kruskal and Prims. These are really, really important, and get an idea on how to solve these questions. Okay, and after that, done with DP, done with graph. Now I think you should study what searching problems like KMP algo. I think most of you might not know this, but those who know this, is a really great algo for searching a string in another string. Okay, and after that, we have an even better searching algo, and that is RevenCarp. Okay, so just look into these and get an idea, because you know, the questions of this round 1 of Virtusa hack, sorry, neural hack of this Virtusa, they were really great, and the, you know, the format in which they execute their code, they had different time complexity cases, they have different boundary conditions. So I think the time complexity will definitely be a deciding factor in round 2. So that is why these searching algos, they are really, really important. Why? Because they decrease your time complexity by a lot. And after that, study trees, you know, because trees are really important, and trees might come, who knows. Okay, so after that, I'm not mentioning everything, I'm just mentioning a few topics that I think are really, really important, and just get an idea on how to solve other questions using this. Okay, okay, so firstly, in trees, just look at a question of LCA, which means least common ancestor. Okay, and after that, how to, you know, the height of a tree, the depth of a node. So look into these questions also, these are really important. And after that, something else is left. Okay, I think number theory is also very important, because this can actually reduce your time complexity by a lot. I hope you already have a knowledge of sieve of Eratosthenes and learn prime factorization. So these are the topics that I think are really, really important, and mostly if you can, you know, even study more DP, then it's even better, because DP is really important, and who knows how many questions might come from DP. Now, are there any other topic that I think are important? So firstly, in DP, you have many different approaches. DP is full of questions, and okay, so after this, I think you should learn a little bit of data structures, right? A little bit of different data structures. For data structures, I mean what? For this, I mean exactly not data structures, but I mean like, you should learn heap. KP is really great if you want to find a maximum number, minimum number again and again in order of n complexity. Okay, so just learn heap. You have this heap function, and these all are really, really important. And after that, I don't think a lot is left, but the exam will be proctored. So don't try to cheat or anything, because you know, even in this round, if you were even try to change your tab, then you know what happened, right? You get a red screen and saying that this was the warning. So don't try to cheat, don't try to you know change something, because it will be again a pocket test. So just look into these examples, and nobody's sure, I'm not sure, but this is just an assumption that these kind of questions might come. Why? Because it's round two, right? 25 out of 2500 students, the 25 top 2500 students, right? Out of 50,000 students, only 2500 were selected, and out of these 2500, only 100 will be called for the final round, for the hackathon of 24 hours event. So you know, you just have to prepare accordingly for that 24-hour event. And by the way, you have different streams, right? You have different stream of UI and all those. So I don't think that they matter in round two. Why I'm saying that is because the main purpose of choosing that stream is to you know is in the third round. Why? Because in third round you will be provided some sort of problem, and you'll have to you know code for 24 hours and come up with a solution. So that is where your stream that you have chosen comes into the main act. Okay, if you have chosen UI development, then maybe you have to form a UI. Okay, if you have chosen a data science, then you might have to you know solve some side of a machine learning algo or something like that. And if you're choosing data Java, then who knows what might happen. So I think they won't have a major effect in the second round, but if they have, then the best thing that can happen is you know maybe your languages will be limited. Okay, so if you are in UI, I think you will only get C sharp. If you are in data science, then I think you will only get Python. And if you are in full stack Java development, then I think you will only get Java. But that is not a major issue. Why? Because you have only chosen those streams because you know those languages, right? Or so I'm assuming. But I think you know that. Okay. So learn different data structures for different languages, because DS will make your code a lot easy and a lot more understandable, a lot more quicker, a lot more optimized. So learn DS. DS is very important. And after that, learn all this DP, graph, searching, and trees. We have only 7 days left, and not a lot of time, because you know we have coded around two, and Cape Gemini is also announcing their dates, and many different companies are announcing at the same time. You have Hack with Infi, what interviews, you have Infosys interviews. So we don't have much time yet, and just go through it and look all these. And if you have something else to learn, do it also, because you know these are not hard coded or the syllabus of Virtusa, but let's just assume that these might come and learn this. Okay, so thank you.